we are going to do is before starting this video, I have cleared up this canvas and deleted all the process which we have used in previous videos. So what we are going to do is let's read a file from one directory and using NiFi processors move it to different directory. So for that one, let's download some sample CSV files. If you already have some CSV files, you don't need to follow this step, but I'm just going to download some sample CSV files. So before starting this video, I was looking into this CSV file which has data related to cities. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to download this CSV file on our server. So currently we are in the NiFi home directory. What I will do is create a directory called input files, and let's go inside input files, and inside this we can download the CSV file. So I'll run wget and followed by the CSV file name. Okay, so now if we do ls-lrt, we can see the file has successfully been downloaded. If I do head -2 and try to read first two records of this CSV file, we are successfully able to read it. Also, just to give you bit of more description about this CSV file, let's try to read top 10 head records. Alright, so yeah, so this is a CSV file which is delimited by comma, so typical CSV file, and this we have kept under home NiFi admin input files directory. So I'm going to read this file, and let's say we want to move it to output directory. So I'm going to create one more directory which is called, so right now I'm back to /home/NiFi admin directory, and here I'm going to create output files. And so our goal will be to read the file, to read cities.csv file from this directory and write it to output files using NiFi processors. So let's go to NiFi processor, and for this purpose, whenever you want to read a file, you can use getFile processor, and whenever you want to write the file, you can use putFile processor. Okay, so let's configure both of them one by one. Right click on the getFile and then select configure, and then you will be getting one properties window where you can configure a lot of stuff. The easiest way to open property window is you can just select double click on the any processor and it will open the properties window. So here in the input directory, I'm going to define the input directory's location, which is home NiFi admin input files, and also we need to tell our file name in the file filter. So the name of our file is cities.csv, so I'm going to copy and paste it from here. And we can also define the behavior, that what we want to do after the file is read. So let's say, do we want to continue keeping the source file at the source location, or do we want to remove it? So if we want to remove it, we can continue keeping keep source file to false. Otherwise, we can just select keep source file to true. That will not remove this file from the source location. So in my case, I'm just going to keep it true. I don't want this file to be removed because this is just the demo session. But in production and based on your use case, this may be a different scenario. And there is a whole lot of other stuff which we can set up here, like minimum file age. It will look for the file age, and based on that only it will be transferring that file. So I think in this tab, properties tab, that's pretty much what we wanted to do. Let's go to scheduling tab, and change this run schedule from 0 second to, let's say, 60 seconds. If we keep it 0, it will try to read the file as many times as possible. And since we have kept keep source file true, it means it will copy the same file probably thousands of times within seconds. So I don't want to do that. So we have changed it to 60 seconds. So this will run once every minute. So I'm going to click on apply. And after that, we can connect this get file. So once we read the file, we want to connect it to put file. And again, as in our previous video, we have seen relationship. So get file has a relationship of success. So once the file is successfully read, it is going to perform the next action. Basically, it is once the file is successfully read, then only it will be transferring that file to put file. In the put file, again, let's go to the properties by double clicking on put file and then going to directory. So this is the directory where we want to copy the file. This is our target directory. So in the target directory, path of our target directory is home/nifi admin/output files. So I'm just going to copy and paste from here. And then the second property which we have is conflict resolution strategy. What we want to do if the file already exists in the target. Do we want to just fail this job, or do we want to ignore it, or do we want to replace the target file with this new file? So probably in my case, I just want to replace the target file. And how about the directories? Let's say if I wanted to move this file to any directory which is not created yet. In that case, what kind of action we wanted to do? Do we want to create those missing directories? If it is true, it will create that directory. If it is not true, then it will just fail, saying that it could not find the location of the directory. Okay, so that's pretty much it which we wanted to set in this job. And let's also change the scheduling of this one to probably every 60 seconds. In fact, in this case, even we don't change it to 60 seconds and just keep it 0 seconds, it's just going to behave the same, because basically it is going to check whether the file exists or not from the source. And it's then, since we have our get file running once every 1 minute, the put file is also going to behave the same. Now, if you have noticed here, we still get some warning. And if you read the warning carefully, this is talking about relationship, that it has relationships, failure and success, but we have not defined what to do for those relationships. So ideally, each processor is supposed to either, you know, have some relationship by transferring data from one processor to another, or it is supposed to have a self-terminating relationship. So in this case, what I'm going to do is, let's double click on this processor and go to settings, and we do not have any further processor to transfer this data from. So we just want to select failure and success. So what it will do is, both of these relationship will be auto terminated. And as you can see now, we do not have any warning message now, and both of them are currently in stop stage. So I'm just going to start the first one and see whether we are able to read it. Okay, so as you can see, the file has successfully been copied and it is currently kept in the buffer, which is also called queue. So if we right click on this and we click on list queue, we should be seeing a flow file. And if we click here on the view content, we should be able to see the content of this flow file. So yeah, this is the file, sample file, which we have downloaded, and now we are able to read this file using get file processor. And now I'm going to write this file to output directory by running put file. So let's right click here and click on start. Okay, so if we see, this processor has completed one task. So it received, in the in section we can see it received one input file, and then it read around this much data and wrote around 8.21 KB of data, and it doesn't have any output relationship, so the output of this is not going anywhere, so that's why in the out we do not see anything. Whereas if you see in the out of get file, you see that there are this many, you know, KBs of data which has been transferred, and also you get a bit of statistics about you know, task timing and all those stuff. So now let's go back to the server and see whether we have any file created in output files directory. So yes, we are currently in output file directory, and let's do ls hyphen lrt. Okay, so as we can see here, now the file has successfully been transferred from source directory to the target directory. So in next video we'll be learning about reading one CSV file and then probably doing some processing and then moving the file to the destination. In this case, we just copied the file from one location and then we moved it to different location. Now let's consider a scenario where you have to download, where you have to copy a file from one server to another server. Okay, in that case, if you use getFile processor, it is not going to work. So getFile and putFile probably works when you are performing the operation on the same server. Okay, so when we want to read a file from a different server, we have to use getSFTP and putSFTP processor.